Hey guys, the question is, Erie Company manufactures a mobile fitness device called the Jogging Mate. The company uses standards to control its cost. The latest standards that have been set for one Jogging Mate are as follows. Here is the data. What is the standard labor hours allowed to make 20,000 Jogging Mates? So here, standard labor hours, first, standard labor hours allowed to make 20,000 units of the jogging mat are equal to 20,000 jogging mates multiplied by 18 minutes divided by total 60 minutes, then it is equal to 20,000 divided by 60 multiplied by 18. So it is equal to 6,000 hours. Second point is, what is the standard labor cost allowed to make 20,000 jogging mates? So standard labor cost allowed to make jogging mates is equal to total number of hours 6,000 hours multiplied by cost per hour $17. So here $6,000 multiplied by $17 is equal to $1,200. Now the third point is, what is the labor spending variance? Labor spending variance. Labor spending variance is equal to standard hours multiplied by standard rate minus actual hours multiplied by actual rate. So here standard hours are 6,000 multiplied by standard rate is $17 minus actual hours. Actual hours are 5,750 multiplied by actual rate. Actual rate is the direct labor cost total. So here we will less total cost, actual cost. 1,203.50. So here it will be equal to 350, which is unfavorable. So labor spending variance is 350, which is unfavorable because our actual cost is higher than standard cost. Sorry, our standard cost is higher than our actual labor cost. No. Labor spending variance will be unfavorable here. Now the fourth point is, what is the labor rate variance and labor efficiency variance? So labor rate variance actual hours minus standard actual hours multiplied by standard rate minus actual rate. Here our actual hours are 5750 minus standard rate $17 minus actual rate. Actual rate is 102,350 divided by 5750. So it is equal to 17.80. So 5750 minus multiplied by $17 minus 17.80. So here minus 4,600. So labor rate variance is equal to $4,600, and it will be $4,600, and it will be unfavorable because our actual rate is higher than standard rate. Now we will calculate labor efficiency variance. Labor efficiency variance is equal to standard rate multiplied by standard hours minus actual hours. Here standard rate is 17 dollar multiplied by standard hours. Standard hours allowed 6,000 minus actual hours 5,750. So it is equal to 4,250. So labor efficiency variance $4,250, and it will be actual hours are lower than standard hours, but it will be favorable. Now the fifth point is the budgeted variable manufacturing overhead rate is $4 per direct labor hour. During August, the company incurred $21,850 in variable manufacturing overhead cost. Compute the variable overhead rate and variable efficiency variances for the month. So here variable rate variance, variable rate variance is equal to actual hours multiplied by standard overhead rate minus actual overhead rate. Here our actual hours are 5,750 multiplied by standard overhead rate $4 minus actual overhead rate, but the company incurred 21,850. So 21,850 divided by 5,750 hours. 3.80, so 5,750 multiplied by $4 minus $3.8. So here variable rate variance is equal to $5,750 multiplied by 0.2, so it is equal to 1,150. And it will be favorable. Now we will calculate efficiency variance. Efficiency variance is equal to standard rate multiplied by standard hours minus actual hours. Our standard rate is $17. $4 multiplied by standard hours. Standard hours 6,000. 6,000 minus 5,750. So it will be 250, 250 multiplied by 4, $1,000. Efficiency variance is equal to 1,000 favorable. So here are my solution. In case any doubt, you can ask me through comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon.